So we move on to the next category of pronominal verbs, reciprocal verbs. What do you understand by reciprocal verbs? Is two or more subjects perform these actions on each other or with each other, something like that. I know it sounds weird. So basically, two or more subjects perform this action with each other or to each other. Some examples could be, let's say, ekrir. We write to each other. So you want to emphasize on each other. You don't say it twice. I write to Rohit. Rohit writes to me. You don't repeat it, right? You use it like, yeah, we write to each other. When you want to use it like that, we write to each other, instead of those two separate sentences like, I write to him, he writes to me. So what you do? In that case, you want to use this verb as a reciprocal. So it becomes, in that context, if you want to say like, we write to each other, it becomes sekhir, okay? And this way it is called as reciprocal verb. The only catch here is, reciprocal verb, if you want to use a verb like a reciprocal verb, it requires two or more subject. That means you can only conjugate this reciprocal verbs in nu, wu, and your il, el form. That's the only conjugations that are allowed, because only plural is possible. Because as I said, reciprocal verbs will require two or more people to be involved. Okay. Now, before putting up so much theory, let's give examples. Pale is to speak, or to talk. Okay. Now, this is a normal routine ER-ending verb. But sometimes I want to use it as reciprocal when I want to say, we speak to each other. Or even you want to say, we spoke to each other last night, something like that. So in that case, it will become sa pahle, and we will only be using conjugations of this in three subject pronouns, nu, vu, and il, el, right? And the conjugation will become nu, nu, like reflexive verb, palo, vu, pahle, and sa pahle, okay? So let's take an example before we go even ahead of reciprocal use of pale. For example, yeah, simple. Nu, nu, palo. Let's say, tu, le, jour. Nu, nu, palo, tu le jour. Anyone, Rohit, can you tell me the meaning of this?
We speak with each other every day.
Awesome. Remember very well, you cannot use reciprocal verbs for je, tu, or il, el. And even though en means informal we, highly recommend do not use reciprocal with en, because en can also mean third person singular. So there's a confusion. So do not use these three subjects with reciprocal verbs. Let's take more examples so that will become clear. Okay. Another verb is aimer, is to love or to like. Okay. To love or to like. Now,
love is adore. So adore. So I think
adore is to love, but aimer can also be used to say I love. Okay. For example, if you say jatem, okay, it means I love you. If you want to say I like you and I don't love you, which is a difference, right? You should rather say jatem biyan. It means I just like you. I don't like love you, right? Okay. Now we want to say we love each other or they love each other. This time let's make it they love each other. There are two people and they love each other. Okay. We just saw that aimer can be used to say I love you. So in this case, we want to use reciprocal. We don't want to say Anushka loves Virat, Virat loves Anushka. No, we want to just say they love each other. So how do we say that? We make it we use it like same, reciprocal. And can you tell me in this case which subject pronoun I will use?
Il seme.
Yes, nice. Yes, so I will say il sem. That's it. I think they still say it il sem. Not, they don't say il sem. Il sem. I know it sounds bizarre because there's no vowel here, but even then they will say il sem.
D'accord.
Okay, and it means they love each other. So it's a reciprocal activity, reciprocative activity. She loves her, she loves him, and he loves her. Lesbian couple will say elzem, right? If it's a gay couple, we could say ilzem, or if it's a heterosexual couple, we will still say ilzem. Okay, so now there is no rule for this. Like, any action which can be reciprocal in nature can become reciprocal verb. So basically, there's no separate list of reciprocal verbs. So any action which is reciprocal in nature, you can use it as a reciprocal verb. We have aimer, to love, parler, to talk or to speak. This one is a little tricky. So marier is a verb, okay? But it's actually se marier, okay? It's a reflexive verb. Why it's a reflexive verb?
Oh, the action of marriage is on yourself.
Yeah, I mean, you are doing it to yourself, whatever you're doing. Okay, so you are responsible unless you have been kidnapped to get married, which is also possible. But usually, you get married. That's why we say, I got married. Okay? Right? So, it's actually a reflexive verb. If you want to say, I got married, you use it as reflexive. Okay? But if a third person is saying, like, I am saying about a marriage of somebody else, right? I could say, they got married. Right? In that case, this becomes what, Rupali? In that case, this becomes?
Reciprocal.
Awesome. It becomes reciprocal. Right? For example, I'll take examples of both. For example, reflexive sense mein, jama mahi saswa, I'm getting married tonight. And then, give me an example of reciprocal verb of samahi, reciprocal usage.
Keli, plural.
Hmm.
Sir.
Rupali. Mari, it doesn't change.
Mari. Hmm. Saswa.
Nice. They are getting married tonight. Okay. And, you can even use marier as a normal verb, like not even reflexive, not reciprocal, just marier. What does it mean?
To marry someone off.
Yes, to marry someone off. Like a, who is that person who is, you know, who is the officiating the wedding? What is it he called as?
Father is marrying off the daughter, something like that.
Yeah, father can do, but I think there's a religious person usually, right, who is doing the duty of that. Yeah, so basically this, reverend, right, yeah. So, marie is to marry off, se marie is to get married, and se marie in reciprocal sense is to get married to each other. This can be both reflexive and reciprocal, this exact sentence, right? And the context will decide that, okay? Only the context can distinguish between these two. I mean, it's the same sentence, but it can mean two different things.
It could be like in one case, there are like two people who got married to each other.
That will be, and the other that, case, that will be which case?
That will be reciprocal.
That will be reciprocal. Another case?
And the other case could be like there are like two or three different couples who got married. For example, we are saying they got married at the
usko same time. Usko bolte hai samuhik vivaah.
Haan, community marriage type two.
Yes, community so marriage. Like, yeah, quite a few couples get married together. So we say they are getting married tonight.